Gritty, hard-edged, with a complex and often conflicted protagonist, the hallmarks of classic and the best of today's crime fiction, all are present in The Double, the second installment in a new series by author George Pelecanos. He's also served as a producer and writer for the HBO series The Wire and Tremé. And welcome to you.
Thank you.
This is the second book about this new character. His name is Spiro Lucas, a contemporary private eye, right? 20-something and a Iraq War veteran. Tell me about creating him. Do you need a core character?
I've been talking to criminal defense attorneys in D.C., and I found out that they hired a lot of veterans, men and women, because they were suited for the work. And, they were unafraid to go into the neighborhoods. And also, they like to get up and replicate that experience they had in the Middle East, not the violent aspect of it, but, when you're in the war, you have orders every day. You get up, you have a purpose, you have a mission. And that's sort of what they do on this job. So it was organic to a story. I just thought, well, this is real. I'm gonna
that's
write
how it
this.
Did you want to look at the plight of veterans? Is that sort of behind the scenes of a story like this?
Yeah, I think it's something that's happening now that is being written about, certainly in journalism and in nonfiction, but not in a lot of fiction that I've been reading. And because I lived near the old Walter Reed and I spent a great deal of time there, I had access to the place. I had a lot of material.
And we see him as he develops here. He's a veteran who he insists, and he's confronted about it, he insists that he's not feeling the trauma of the war. And yet, from all his actions, it looks certainly as though it's had an impact.
Exactly. He's in denial of what the war has done to him. And he won't speak about it, even with his closest, his loved ones, his mother and his brother, who he loves very much. But he just won't talk about it. However, the reader sees that there's something really wrong with this guy because of the things he does in these books.
When you're looking into the urban life and especially crime, you're clearly looking at the American justice system as well, right? I mean, are you conscious of that? Is that something that has grabbed you to look at the kind of larger picture behind these stories?
Yeah, I'm really interested in issues of, for example, juvenile justice reform and sentencing and those kinds of things. And I bring all that.
You mean at the nonfiction level, the reality level?
Yeah, but the thing is, I'm always working. If I go visit a prison or a juvenile facility, you can say, well, yeah, he's doing something good. He's turning inmates onto books and things like that. But really, I'm working. I'm working all the time.
That's how it works, huh?
Yeah.
But you bring books to them, and this is something you do sort of on the side, but as you say, it's research and it goes into the books.
Yeah, and I'm involved with the Penn Faulkner organization here in town, where we go into the schools and we bring authors and books to kids. And there are schools in these facilities also. There's a high school at the local juvenile facility. And so we started a program there.
Because one of the things that comes through in your books that I've read, this one again, and in The Wire, the work you've done on television, mm-hmm. is the looking at the socioeconomics of the situation as well. It's not just a crime story. And I don't mean that the crime story is the way into that larger picture, but it's always there, right?
Yeah, I mean, I use the crime fiction part of it as a narrative engine to hang all these things that I want to talk about on. And I don't push that aside. I mean, make no mistake, this is a bang-up crime thriller.
Yep.
I'm proudly a crime writer.
Which means what?
Well, it means that I'm not trying to be, act like I'm something I'm not. I mean, I love crime novels. I got turned on to crime fiction in college, and I immediately knew that I wanted to, that's what I wanted to do.
But you're also not afraid of looking at, I mean, in this book particularly, the character is looking at a Washington, D.C., not the one we cover on this show every night, mm-hmm. about the Capitol and politics, but a Washington, D.C. that has changed in neighborhoods, right, gentrified.
Yeah, that's all seen through the eyes of this guy who's come back from overseas, and he is really amazed at the changes that have happened in D.C. in the last 10 years.
So you're a crime writer, but you're also willing to look at the life in which these things happen.
Yeah, it's everything that I'm interested in and passionate about. I think you can do it. You can talk about these things more clearly in the context of a crime novel. If you take something like Richard Price's Clockers, which kind of kicked the door in for all of these things like The Wire and the books that I write, that's a classic of American literature. That's our Grapes of Wrath, my generation's Grapes of Wrath. You know?
Really?
Yeah.
There's a line in this book where you have your main character, one of the things he does, and it sounds like what you yourself do, bring books to veterans. And he's talking about, he says, like most people, the recovering veterans enjoyed a good story told with clean, efficient writing, a plot involving a problem to be solved or surmounted, and everyday characters the reader could relate to.
Yeah, I think of my dad. He was a veteran of World War II. He fought in the Pacific Marine Corps. And he always had a John D. McDonald on his nightstand, or a Ross McDonald.
You mentioned him in the acknowledgments, I noticed.
I do, because the book is clearly the setup of the character. He takes side jobs, and he recovers lost or stolen property for a fee of 40%. The clear antecedent is Travis McGee, John D. McDonald's character.
So when you say you're proudly a crime fiction writer, what does that mean? How do you define that genre, if that's the right word?
Well, there's a problem to be solved. There's conflict. All drama is conflict, and there's no higher form of conflict than life or death, right? Mm-hmm. And that's what exists in the crime novel. That's what the stakes are.
And how do you differentiate that from the television work? Is one different from another?
I take it as seriously. I mean, I sweat as much blood over a TV script as I do a novel.
You do?
My name's on it.
But writing something for the writing, for example, The Wire,
mm-hmm.
which of course is another version of crime fiction, right?
Yeah, you could say that.
Yeah. Do you enjoy that?
I love it.
Yeah.
I really love it. I love producing. I love being on set with hundreds of people that are artists also, and you're all building something together. It's a completely different experience from writing a novel where I'm in a room by myself. And I get to do that, both of those things for, you know, half the year I'm by myself in a room. The other half I'm working with a bunch of talented people, and I love both.
Half and half, huh?
Yeah.
You've made a life out of it.
Yeah, I'm doing all right.
All right. The new book is The Double, George Pelecanos. Thanks very much.
Thank you.